Though COVID has influenced Costco's new food rules, the superstore chain has long had some strict guidelines, both for employees and customers. From the do's and don'ts of the kitchen to who's allowed to eat at the food court, consider this your unofficial guide to the rules regarding Costco's food. Thinking about applying for a job in Costco's food court, bakery, or meat department? Well, if you're a fan of painted nails, you might want to consider another position, because a trip to the nail salon is going to be wasted money. Nail polish is a no-no for food workers. The primary reason for this isn't that Costco is trying to stifle style, but because of the potential for nail polish to chip and end up in food. That seems like a pretty reasonable argument. Nothing ruins a bite of pizza like looking down and seeing a chip of red nail polish laying on top of a pepperoni. The same goes for acrylic nails. A Costco food safety manual details that employees must have, quote, trimmed and short fingernails, and that no jewelry of any kind can be worn. Not even a watch is allowed. Other departments within Costco likely aren't as strict about employee appearance. Several Costco employees said they got away with sporting facial piercings, but this seemed to depend on how lenient the general manager was.
I never knew the beauty of Costco, and one day I woke up and I had like an epiphany, and I was just like, let's go to Costco.
Nobody wants to eat food that's been touched by dirty hands. It can lead to food poisoning and is just overall gross. It's standard practice for employers to require employees to wash their hands before handling food. Costco, however, takes things a step further and has strict protocol in place when it comes to keeping hands clean. The chain expects its food suppliers have hand washing sinks strategically placed so that food prep employees can wash their hands the second they enter the building and proceed to their workstation with minimal risk of germ infiltration. Those hand washing stations should also be completely hands-free, of course, for extra safety. As far as clean hands are concerned, hand washing is only the first step. If Costco hands are going to be touching any sort of ready-to-eat product, a few squirts of soap simply isn't good enough. Employees are to wear gloves and abide by Costco's written glove policy. The retail chain requires employees to wear either single-use latex-free or reusable gloves, and any reusable gloves must be clean and sanitized before starting a shift or coming back from break. According to an NPR article, Costco sells about 60 million rotisserie chickens each year. Even though the chickens are a loss leader, they're invaluable because most people who buy them are going to venture deeper into the store and make other purchases. The chickens taste great straight out of the bag, and you're pretty much guaranteed to get a fresh one every time.
So what is the secret of these chickens?
Well, it's a larger chicken than you're gonna find in other stores, and then the price.
Yep, just like everything else food-related under the Costco roof, there are certain chicken rules that must be followed. One employee told Business Insider, "Our famous rotisserie chickens are not allowed to be sold after 2 hours of sitting in the warmer. Any chickens that aren't sold within the 2-hour time frame are turned into soup." The employees who handle those rotisserie chickens can also be seen wearing aprons, gloves, hairnets, hats, and beard nets if they have facial hair. With the $5 chickens being such a big part of Costco's food strategy, it's understandable why they take rotisserie chicken safety seriously. Walk into any Costco bakery and you'll see rows of breads, pastries, and cakes all ready to be sold. So what happens to all that food that doesn't make it off the shelves? Foods such as baked goods are often donated to food pantries. Some produce products even find their way into city zoos or various animal sanctuaries. One Costco employee said the food court is incredibly strict about throwing away food, even before a customer touches it. The employee explained, "Let's say a member asks for a slice of cheese pizza. We place that piece onto a plate with tongs, of course, then place the plate onto the counter. If the member says, 'Oh darn, I've changed my mind, I'd rather have pepperoni pizza,' then we have to toss the pizza that they didn't want into the trash. The customer doesn't even have to touch the plate. We're not faulting Costco here. Gambling with food safety isn't worth the risk. It's that sort of customer indecisiveness that contributes to food waste, though. So choose wisely." Costco's food court is a serious moneymaker. According to CNN, those hot dogs and popular rotisserie chickens that shoppers love to buy help the food court pull in nearly $1 billion annually for Costco. Considering that the food court is a money-making machine, it's only natural that Costco would be serious about its food court safety. Some Costco employees believe that the chain uses the food court as a testing ground for new employees to see if they have what it takes. One employee said, "If you start in a food department, especially food court, bakery, deli, etc., it is hard to get out, as none of these departments are remotely easy to work in, and they will be less likely to move you out if you are a good worker." Another employee said that newbies either start out pushing carts or food court, but hang in there, pass your 90 days, and reap the benefits. "Look for job postings in the break room. I went food court to cashier to membership in a year and a half." Like every grocery store in the United States and much of the world, the COVID-19 pandemic threw Costco for a loop. All of a sudden, normal operations came to a halt and a whole new set of rules had to be put into place. This was especially apparent when it came to food and drink. At the end of March 2020, Costco temporarily did away with its food sample servers out of concern regarding virus transmission. Having potentially hundreds of customers a day grabbing free pretzel bites understandably seemed too risky. According to the Chicago Sun-Times, when Costco did finally bring back the popular free food samples in June 2020, obviously there were some new rules in place. Rather than offer food items like freshly made meatballs, the free samples would only be packaged items, kept behind a protective plexiglass shield. It might not have been the free food extravaganza that Costco shoppers were used to, but the president of Costco's club demonstration services said it was necessary to make sure we are taking the right steps to engage members safely. One of the telltale signs that we had entered a new normal in the early months of the pandemic was the absence of certain grocery items in stores. First, it was toilet paper, then foods like bread and even yeast. It wasn't just panic buying that impacted grocery stores like Costco, but the production of those foods and products. Meat processing plants slowed production in the early months of the pandemic, and this led to fewer items finding their way to grocery shelves. Costco shoppers who entered stores in May 2020 were met with new rules that limited the amount of meat they could buy. Where pre-pandemic, a shopper could stock up on a month's worth of beef, shoppers could now only purchase 3 products of beef, pork, or poultry at a time. There were also rules about what Costco shoppers could bring into the store. A Costco regular said a manager told them they couldn't walk around the store with the iced mocha they'd purchased from the outdoor food court. Another shopper informed them that the policy was most likely put in place to reduce the risk of transmission from shoppers constantly removing their face masks to nosh on snacks. Yes, mochas are delicious, but not worth the risk of spreading COVID. Costco may have a lot of rules in place regarding how its food is prepared, sold, and even consumed in the store, but when it comes to food returns, it's almost anything goes. Or at least it used to be. The chain's lax return policy has become somewhat of a Costco trademark, and this has led to people returning all sorts of food products that most grocery stores would not. The craziest items that people have returned to Costco have been well documented and include everything from liquefied watermelon to frozen fish that was over a decade old. But in December 2020, Costco put its foot down regarding certain items that people had hoarded and now wanted to return. Among non-food items like toilet paper and Lysol, Costco was no longer accepting returns on water or rice. As for the current company rules on returning a garbage bag of liquefied watermelon, just please don't. The whole point of Costco's rules regarding food, of course, is to avoid selling its customers contaminated products. A food poisoning scandal can cost a company millions in lawsuits and lost profits due to customer distrust. Even with the strict protocol Costco has in place for its employees and vendors, a few food poisoning episodes have slipped through the cracks. For example, in 2011, at least 20 people fell ill after eating bad cantaloupe, and many of those folks bought the fruit from Costco, reported the New York Times. While the fruit was traced back to a farm in Guatemala owned by produce giant Del Monte, the incident no doubt led to concerned Costco shoppers skipping over the melons on subsequent shopping trips. Then in 2018, Costco was hit with a lawsuit by a woman who claimed some bad chicken salad she had purchased led to E. coli poisoning and ultimately led to her requiring a kidney transplant. Costco and the woman eventually reached an undisclosed agreement. Avoiding this sort of thing and the financial fallout that can follow, though, is exactly why Costco means business when it comes to food safety rules. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more mashed videos about your favorite stores are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.